actually you can use this picture without cutting it in these two parts, but I decided to do it and to separate the front view. One question: do you think this material from today is useful for you or no?
Well, I think everything is useful for us.
Okay. Because you are graphic designers, not game designers, actually.
Sorry, Svetoslav, I think that today's situation is half by half, maybe. Also, a few interior students are presented. But anyway, most of the company is in graphic design.
Okay, that's good. Actually, it's not, I think, a problem that you see this lecture. Because I'm a graphic designer too, but I'm asking only. Okay, I separated these two plans, and this is the front view, one of our viewports. Actually, as you can see, this is front, side, and the top view. Front view, one important thing. While you prepare your viewports for this kind of modeling, you don't have to resize to zoom, actually, any of these viewports. This one, the perspective view, isn't so important for this, but the others is important to stay in this position. Import image. One other important thing for me is a good idea when I start something new. To create a new project, because the program sorry, I have some problem with my voice this morning, because the program creates all these folders in the main folders of the project. In the main folder of the project, and every file, and different kinds of files are related with these folders. That's the reason I prefer to use new project and the program to make connection with all of these folders. 3D, maybe something like this, and now the program knows that we work in this project, and I'll take from desktop my blueprints, and I'll move them in this folder. Get 3D source images. Maybe it's a good idea to save the scene at first. And we are starting to import the image in the scene. As I said before, the program knows where these files. The front view is here. Okay. And we are going to see the next side view. Import image, side view, but the position isn't in the right direction. Have some problem here with this plane. This is our decision. I'll change the contrast a little bit of the image. It's a good idea to be exactly in the center of the viewport. create earlier for the planes, because I don't want to select them every time when I don't to do it. Okay, we have two possibilities to start this modeling. The first one is box modeling. Maybe is a good idea to start with this kind of modeling, because the project, actually not the project exactly, the model, the this cat is a simple model, and we can use this kind of modeling, and the typical thing here is we're starting with a simple object like box, and we are going to increase the resolution of the object when we need it. Maybe you know how to view only one of the viewports when you need to see it a little bit bigger. The shortcut is space button. This is the longest button in the keyboard. I'm dividing this object in two parts, and I'm deleting one of them. And I'll create another half of the object, but instance copy, and because I want to work in only one of the halves of the object, and the other will repeat the actions. I'll reset the settings, and I'll do it again. Instance copy, scale in X with negative. Yes, and that's it. Now I start to move these points in the right position. Maybe something like this in the beginning. Okay, and when we are ready, we can start to extrude another faces. This button here is important because it orients the position of the polygon as the position of the world. Oops, not here. Okay, maybe we need more resolution here. And we'll use insert edge loop function. We can choose the last used command from here, from the hotbox menu, recent commands, not to search them in the menu. Seems a little bit like a snake. Here we have extra polygons which we don't need actually. But maybe it's a good idea before this action to freeze transformations. To reset the transformations in zero, which action was good idea to do at the beginning, but I forgot to do it. It's not big problem, actually. But it's important thing. The neck is the next time. Next thing which we'll do. Control E is the shortcut of extrude command. When you once use extrude command with Ctrl E or from the menu, it's important to move the polygons because they are here on the place where we used the command extrude, and if you forget to move them, they will overlap with the first one, and that actually will be a problem in the next steps. Which are UV mapping and animation. I'll extrude the ears from here. Idea to increase a little bit the resolution of the objects. Maybe one here. Actually, we'll need a little bit a little bit more resolution in this section here, because we have to create the ice in this place. Very big eyes. We don't need from this polygon here, because I'll use a sphere for the ice, and I'll insert another one group of polygons, but only in this part here.